My name's Laura Deas. I slide for the Great Britain skeleton team. And this is how I do it.
So Laura, tell me then, do your friends and family think you're completely mad?
Yeah, they do, but they know I've always been into adrenaline sports. There are risks. You're travelling 80 miles an hour down an ice chute, so to say it's not risky would be silly. I've never felt out of my depth or out of control. It's always been more about a little bit of fear tinged with excitement rather than abject terror.
What kind of G-forces do you experience going down?
Well, we experience anything up to 5 Gs normally, which is the same sort of pressure that fighter pilots would experience in a plane.
What does that feel like? Someone just really heavy sitting on top of
you? Yeah, basically. Yeah, just being pressed really hard into your sled, and then obviously for me, it's my head going down and touching the ice as well.
Hurling herself down an ice run wasn't how she started her sporting career. She was a professional event rider and captained the Wales tetrathlon team before switching to skeleton.
How come you're here doing or sliding down these ice slopes on a skeleton?
Well, I came into the sport 5 years ago through a UK sport talent spotting programme. So since then I've been sort of working away, making sure my push is getting quicker and quicker. I'm getting better at the sliding. Just working up my way through the international tiers and to finally make it up onto the World Cup circuit.
Well, so tell me about it. So you were obviously fairly sporty at school, sporty teenager, but you wanted to event, you wanted to do horses full time?
Yeah, that was always my original goal, and I was doing that full time when I tried out for skeleton. So it was a bit of a tough decision actually to switch to skeleton, but I felt it was a really good opportunity to try and make it onto a British team and then hopefully an Olympic team. I was 19 when I first got on a sled, and I mean, by European standards, they're at the peak of their career at that stage because they start so much younger. So, but I mean, as a programme, we're totally geared up to that. We know we're kind of taking on a challenge, and so people are a little bit older when they start, but it means they're more mature and they can pick things up quicker. And I think also because the circuit's quite tough, physically and mentally, it actually does us good to be a little bit older and more mature when we first kind of step out there.
Despite not having any ice tracks to practice on in the UK, Britain has become extremely successful on the world stage. Lizzie Yarnold won Olympic gold in Sochi this year, repeating Amy Williams' achievement in 2010.
It is a little bit mad when you think about it like that at first, but actually when you dig a bit deeper, we've drilled into exactly what we need to do when to get the most out of the ice time that we do get, make sure it's really good quality. So what we lose in time, I think we gain in the quality of what we do, and we've got the right people in the right places to get the most out of everything.
And what's your best part of the slide then?
I've kind of always been known for my push because I'm a fast pusher, but I like to think now that my driving is catching up, and so when I head out onto World Cup, I don't just want to be known as the girl that can push the sled fast, I want to get to the bottom of the hill fast as well.
So what next for you then on the World Cup squad, which really means I suppose you're in with the world's best, it's not the second ranked Intercontinental Cup, so yeah. You'll be able to sort of really judge where you are in the world stage?
Yeah, it's really exciting because it's the first time I'll be able to actually sort of judge myself like for like against the best in the world, so that's really exciting. But in my mind, I don't really want to start approaching it from a different point of view because I like to kind of keep the continuity of what I've been doing the last few years and building on that. I'm hopeful, I'm excited, but I don't want to kind of pin myself, put too much pressure on myself initially.
And next Olympics, those are the ones you're really gunning for?
Yeah, definitely. That's real kind of goal on the horizon now, and it's actually not that far away. I think I read something the other day. One of my coaches said to me it was 32 races between now and the next Olympics. So when you think of it in that sense, it's actually not very far away at all.